Do I have a month of buying for you guys? Today's what I bought this month, what worked, what didn't, what was worth the money, what wasn't, is quite jam-packed. My wallet is not okay with it, but I'm hoping I can give you guys some helpful reviews or things that worked and some things that didn't. Little Miss got some stuff this month, didn't you? Oh, is that the spot? So I definitely have some doggo stuff to show you guys. I have some drinks that I tried. I have some new clothes that I've tried. It's literally a very well-rounded list of things that I bought this month. So we're gonna dive right in. But if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe down below. I do these kinds of videos every single month where I break down everything that I bought this month and give you guys the rundown on like what I loved, what I didn't love. That way, if you guys have been looking into potentially trying something new, you at least know one person's review.
Excuse me. Oh my goodness.
She has been such a sleepy baby all day today. You're so tired. But also don't forget to follow me over on Instagram because there's a lot of things that I show you guys over there that never make it to a vlog. So if you want to see like everything that I get and like honest reviews or just like how things are working in my daily life, make sure you're subscribed and make sure you follow me on Instagram. Should we start with your stuff?
Start with the doggo stuff?
First up are these hats that I got Griffin and I. So the black one is of course mine. It says Dog Mom on it. This one is Griffin's and it says Padre. I love my hat. It's just a normal baseball cap, but I am kind of picky about mine because I don't know if I just have like a weirdly shaped head, but I do not like when I wear my hats and if this side piece goes like over my ear, you know, I want it to like fit just right, and it does other than when I'm not wearing braids. The quality is really, really nice. And then Griffin loves 5-panel hats. I don't know if it's like a dude thing, I don't know, but Griffin loves it. He wears this all the time, especially when we go to like the dog parks and stuff. Also really, really good quality. These are from the same Etsy shop. And of course, I guess I should have said this before, everything that I talk about today will be linked down below, even the things that I might not really, really like, because what may not work for me may work for you. So everything will be linked down below, but these are from the same little Etsy shop. Now, this collar is not new. I got this a long time ago. It's been in other like dog haul videos. It's like a little 80s, 90s themed kind of collar, but I like to have a dog tag with every collar. That way I don't have to really switch them out. I can just grab a collar and go. So I've been on the market for like a little 80s, 90s themed dog tag to go with this collar, and I found one. This one is so cute. It's like round and it's not the perfect pink color, but it matches the purple that's also in this collar. Just finding like a retro kind of dog tag might be hard to do, so I'm gonna link this one down below because I really like it. I also got 3 things from a different Etsy shop, and I have hauled this in a pup date video, so if you guys seen that video, you've already seen this, but I'm still gonna show it here in case you haven't seen them because they're freaking adorable. So I got these 2 shirts and they have Freya's face on them. It has Freya's name on them. I think they're so freaking cute, and obviously as you can see from like the colors behind me, very much my vibe, very much my color aesthetic. Like, it's simple, it's cute, I think it's adorable, and it looks just like her because it is. Like, I submitted photos to her and she like drew them all out. And from the same girl, I got this Starbucks cup, which of course says Dog Mom on it, and then on the back it has my name that matches like the turquoise straw on it. So freaking cute. I love the colors of this. I love that it's like a Dog Mom thing. I just really like Dog Mom stuff. I'm obsessed with my dog. Sorry. The next thing that Freya is currently playing with is this dog toy that Griffin and I got from the mall. Excuse me, I've got to show to people. And we got 2 of them. One is currently in Griffin's car, so I can't show it to you. It's by the brand. Where is it? Did you rip the brand tag off? The Worthy Dog, but it's supposed to be like really tough chew toys. And so far, she hasn't chewed any pieces off. She has ripped a few pieces. If you can see right here on the tail is kind of ripped. Ear on the strap is a little bit ripped. Like, nothing's off yet. She hasn't like completely torn a limb off, but she's definitely like broken a few seams. So it's not completely indestructible. If you have a super chewer, it's probably not gonna work because she's not a super chewer, but she can chew through some stuff and she's already like getting through it. Okay, you can have it. And the last doggo item I have is this bandana, which is so cute. I love the colors of this. And it's actually from a collab from a friend of mine on Instagram. And her brand is So Fetch, and she did a collab with this bandana company to make like a reversible bandana. So one side says So Fetch and the other side is like the colorful side. It's so freaking cute. And she launched a whole bunch of stuff, like physical products. I have a couple others to show you, but there were like Dog Mom stickers that I bought that are on my water bottle and just all over. So happy for her. Next, let's talk about workout clothes. So I have like 3 or 4 new things to show you, all of which kind of obsessed with. So the first one is this top, which I wore to the farmer's market the other day. And it's like a workout top. I like the back of it. It has the built-in bra with it. It's from Old Navy. And I just like it because it's the perfect crop, so you can wear it as the tank top. So I just wore it as like a normal outfit and like as a normal shirt, which was what I prefer because I have a similar top to this in like a purple color that I love wearing all the time. So I saw this black one and I wanted to get kind of like a basic stable black one. 10 out of 10. Also, while I was at Old Navy, I found the best things to ever exist. And And at least to me, I've never seen them before. I might just be like really, really, really late to the game, but I wish these would have existed like 6 years ago, and this is my first year having them. I'm currently wearing a pair of them right now, but these are workout jogger leggings. At least to me, when I think of joggers, I think of like sweatpants, and I get kind of too hot for that stuff, especially if you are gonna wear them for working out. But I love yoga pants, but sometimes I don't want something that tight. So the yoga pant joggers are like the same yoga pant material as like leggings or yoga pants, but loose. They're super high-waisted, which is what I really like. So they go like super high all the way around. They have pockets, and then they're tight at the ankles. Like, it's perfect. Where has this been all my life? 10 out of freaking 10. I did size up because they are supposed to be looser, you know, and I usually wear a small in pants, but the smalls were like basically yoga pants again. So I got mediums just to kind of give you that heads up. I would size up, but I got this pair as well, which the color is adorable for fall. So excited to wear this. I think it'll look beautiful with the black top too. Ugh, literally so pumped, but I just haven't worn them yet. So if you're looking for the tag, this is what they are. And I'm going to live in these for fall. To my ladies, right now I'm wearing like normal underwear, so you can kind of see underwear lines. They're not see-through, but you can see the lines of the underwear, which is like, to me, I don't care because I'm chilling at home all day. But a nice little like secret, if you wear a thong with them, ugh, your butt looks so good. I cannot recommend these enough. Like, absolutely obsessed with them. I want like 72 pairs. The last workout outfit I got is from Fabletics. I am like a VIP from them, so I buy all of these myself. None of this stuff is sponsored in any of this video, but I usually skip every month because like I'm not trying to spend that kind of money, but I forgot to last month, so I got a credit and I got an outfit. I let you guys help me pick on my Instagram stories of like which color I should get, so I found some that I liked. You guys voted on brown, so I got the brown set, and it's the prettiest brown I've ever seen. It's gorgeous. There's like whatever, this is like giraffe print, I don't really know, but the detailing on it, the printing on it, so cute. They're super high-waisted. In the power hold leggings, I'm a small, but in whatever material these are, I forget already, I'm a medium. But if you have not shopped at Fabletics before, a lot of their materials are different, so keep that in mind, that like in one material you might be one size, in another you're another. I got a medium in the top as well, but I probably should have sized down to a small because I have like excess material on the sides, like on the side of your boobs, you know what I mean? And I wore this with like a flannel the other day and it looked gorgeous. And again, it's fall colors and I'm obsessed with it. While we're on the topic of clothing, I went on a jean hunt earlier this month. I had a vlog of it, trying to look for the perfect pair of mom jeans. And I didn't find what I was looking for, but I found more things. So I got three pairs of jeans. One is from Old Navy that I've tried on and they fit just fine. I just haven't worn them yet, so the tag is still on them. This is called an extra high rise sky high straight. So it's not really a mom jean, but it's a straight leg. But I do think it's really, really cute. They were kind of pricey for me because I usually find all my jeans either at Target or at Plato's Closet. So I spend no more than like 20 bucks on jeans. These ones were $44.99. Like, I know it's not a terrible price for jeans. It's quite normal, but just for me, it was kind of out of my price range. But I do really like them, so I got them. And then while Griffin and I were at the mall, when we got like that dog toy for Freya, Aeropostale had a sign out that was like buy one, get one free on their jeans. And that was literally the day after I was looking for the perfect pair of mom jeans. So we went inside to check them out. And I found this pair, which are probably my favorite out of the two that I got. And it's just a mom jean, like the perfect mom jean fit black jean. I don't own a pair of black jeans and I love these. But like the vibe is so cute. I love the fit. The material feels good. It's kind of stretchy, like all around a good jean find. But since it was buy one, get one free, I couldn't leave without getting another pair of jeans because I thought that was dumb of me to not take advantage of a free pair of jeans. So I got this pair, which looks quite similar to the other pair. However, they're a different wash. At least in my head, these ones are more bluey. These ones are more like whitewashed and like gives you like a retro-y vibe or like, I don't know, grunge. Not really, but like that's where I would wear these ones for versus these ones I would wear to like work. I actually wore this to a race this past weekend. So like these are just normal jeans. Both of them don't have holes, which is good. And then even though it's about to be fall and like shorts are going out, I found this pair of shorts at Target. Sorry, there's someone mowing their lawn. Are you serious? But I found these at Target and I loved them. I love the way they fit. I don't really know why. I like that there's no holes, so I can wear these ones to work a little bit easier, at least for the last few weeks that I can. I wasn't on the hunt for shorts, but the shorts found me. We're in my office because this next product also came from my friend's product launch, the same friend that launched the bandana. She has a whole bunch of stuff, the stickers, all that kind of stuff. She launched some notepads. I live in to-do lists and sticky notes and all of that kind of stuff. So I got this to-do list and I think this notepad is so cute. I love the colors on it. I love the fun fonts. I like how big the lines are because I write big. Usually if I buy like a to-do list from Target or something, I have to write so tiny And I don't know, for me, this is literally perfect. And then I'll fill this up every day, write some notes down at the bottom. I can check it off when I do it or just cross it out. And I'm obsessed. We're in the kitchen for my last item, even though I have none to show you because I finished them all and I made my friends drink them all, because I think this is the first one that just definitely has like a two thumbs down rating for me. And that is the Alani Nu seltzers. Now I will say, after I drank more of them, I got kind of used to them and I finished them or had my friends finish them. Like, it wasn't something that I couldn't drink, but compared to other seltzers, they weren't my favorite. I don't know. I will not buy them again. When I first bought them, y'all were in my DMs. Literally like 80% of you said they're trash. And then the other 20% were saying that like, there's only two flavors that you liked or that they were good. So I feel like it's a very, you either love them or you don't. So try them for yourself and let me know. But I was not a fan. But that is all I have for you for this month. It was quite a lot of stuff, at least in my opinion. But I hope you enjoyed taking a look at what I bought this month and what I liked and what I didn't. Make sure you subscribe down below, that way you don't miss out on future videos like this. And also don't forget to follow me over on Instagram, because there's tons of stuff that I show you guys over there that never make it to the videos. I know that in October, I'm gonna be buying probably a lot of things. So next month's video is gonna be quite long too, because I am doing Vlogtober, which means I'm vlogging every single day in October from the 1st all the way until the 31st leading up to Halloween. Kind of like Vlogmas, but for Halloween. And I'm really freaking excited. So we're gonna be doing a whole bunch of stuff. There's already like a decor haul video that I need to do, some dog spooky stuff, whatever. So make sure you subscribe down below and you don't miss out on those videos. But I love you guys so much, more than you'll ever know. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.